In this video, I'm going to explain about the phase shift keying method. First, I tell the definition. It is the digital modulation technique in which the phase of the carrier waves changes according to the binary values of modulating signal. So this is nothing but the definition for phase shift keying. So it is a digital modulation technique. It is another form of angle modulation. Okay, it is another form of angle modulation. So once again I am telling them definition. Phase of the carrier signal is changes with respect to the binary values of modulating signal is called phase shift keying. It is also called BPSK, binary phase shift keying, because the carrier signal is changes with respect to the binary values of modulating signal. Due to that it is also called binary phase shift keying. Multi-level PSK is possible, like 4-level PSK, 8-level PSK, depends on the need of the system. I will explain how it is 4-level and 8-level. Okay. If the number of bits, I mean if the binary input is 1, then we can find out the length of the bit, 2 power n, by using 2 power n. N is nothing but a number of bits. It may be 1. We are having two possible phases. In phase changes may be 0 degree or 180 degree. If the number of input bit is 2, 4 possible phases are available. 0 degree, 90 degree, 180 degree and 270 degree. If the number of binary input is 3, 3 bits are available in the input side, 8 possible phases are available. 0 degree, 45 degree, 90 degree, 135, 180, 225, 270 and 315 degree phases are available. So if it is 1 bit means the binary input may be either 0 or 1. If it is 2 bit means 2 digit binary values means the possible binary inputs may be 00, 01, 10 and 11. If n is 3 means it may be 00, 0, 001, 010, 011, 100, 110 and 111. So these are all the possible binary inputs. So it depends on this, possible phases are available in the carrier wave. So these binary values modulates the carrier signal that generates a phase shifted modulated signal, which is termed as phase shift keying signal, BPSK signal. Okay, so depends on the binary values, carrier wave undergoes the phase shifted modulated signal, which is called as PSK signal or BPSK signal. So this is the PSK waveforms, okay. This is nothing but the binary data we are giving, 1100, 0011, 0100, 0010. This is the example binary bit sequence. So this is the binary data sequence. And the second one represents the bipolar NRZ signal, non-return to zero signal representation for the binary data we are giving. Okay, so this is the bipolar NRZ sequence waveform for the binary data. Okay, 1-1 is on signal, 0-0-0-0 is off signal. For 1, we have to draw the on signal, for 0, we have to draw the off signal. And the third waveform represents the carrier waveform. And the final one is nothing but the PSK waveform. So if the data, when bit changes from, okay, when bit changes from 1 to 0, okay, when bit changes from 1 to 0, so this is the amplitude, plus 1 and minus 1. So here the data changes from 1 to 0, okay, so here the data bit sequence changes from 1 to 0, negative phase changes of carrier signal is available, okay. The data sequence, when bit changes from 1 to 0, negative phase reversal takes place. When the bit sequence changes from 0 to 1, okay, if it is 0 to 1, positive phase changes takes place. So in this way we have to draw the PSA waveform. Okay, so the data changes from 1 to 0. Okay, the data changes from 1 to 0. We have to draw the negative waveform. So the same side we have to draw the waveform. If it is changes from 0 to 1, positive side we have to start. Okay, can you get the idea to draw the PSK waveform? Okay, the data sequence changes from 1 to 0, we have to start the negative side. If it is changes from 0 to 1, okay, if it is binary data changes from 0 to 1, we have to start the positive side. So this is the PSK waveform. So the carrier wave phases changes with respect to the binary values of modulating signal, so that it is also called a phase reversal keying method. For binary data 1, we are getting 0 degree phase shift of carrier signal. For binary data 0, we are getting 180 degree phase shift of carrier signal. Okay, if it is 1, we are getting 0 degree phase shift. If it is 0, we are getting 180 degree phase shift of carrier signal. So I'm going to draw the PSK transmitter diagram or PSK modulation block diagram. Binary input data it may be 0 or 1. So here level converter, balanced modulator, buffer, reference carrier oscillator, reference carrier oscillator, bandpass filter. Here we are getting modulated PSK output waveform as the output. PSP is the output. Okay, so here we are giving the binary input data. It may be either 0 or 1. Then level converter, balanced modulator, bandpass filter. Here we are using buffer and reference carrier oscillator. So the PSP method is also called phase reversal keying method, because phase reversal takes place. Depends on the binary values of the modulating signal. So it is also called as phase reversal keying method. So this is the PSK modulation block diagram. So here we are giving the binary input data. So binary input data may be applied to the level converter. Level converter produces the bipolar NRZ signal. Level converter produces bipolar NRZ signal. That signal may be applied to the balanced modulator. At the same time, reference carrier oscillator apply the carrier signal to the balanced modulator. The output of the balanced modulator is the PSK signal. So from the bandpass filter we are getting the proper PSK signal. So I'm going to explain the balanced modulator operation. So this is the balanced modulator block diagram. So here we are using two transformer, primary, and this is the primary section and this is the secondary section. So here we are giving the reference carrier input. So four diodes are connected like this. These diodes are represented by D1, D2, D3 and D4. So from this side we are getting the BPSK modulated output. I'm going to draw one simple binary input and phase of carrier wave phase. If we are giving a logic 0, 180 degree phase shift are available at the output of the transformer. If we are giving logic 1, 0 degree phase shift we are getting across the transformer. I will tell how we are getting from the balanced modulator. So let us consider logic 1. Okay, first we are going to give logic 1, okay, binary value 1 to the transformer side. Okay, binary 1. At the same time, reference carrier input is also applied across this. So, if you are giving 1, 1 means positive, isn't it? Positive. So, positive is connected to the diode D1, positive side, anode side. So, here also, anode is connected to the positive side. So, D1 and D2 is forward biased. It starts conducting. So, this positive is connected to the negative of D4 and negative of D3. So D3 diode and D4 diode is reverse biased. D1 and D2 is forward biased. So D1 and D2 starts conducting. D3 and D4 won't conduct. So the diode D1 and D2 starts conducting. So that we are getting 0 degree phase shift across the transformer. In phase output. In phase transformer output we are getting. So if we are giving logic 1 means we are getting 0 degree phase shift of the carrier wave. Then if we are giving a logic 0, so here we are giving logic 0 means it is negative, okay, negative value. So the diode D1 and D2 becomes reverse biased. D3 and D4 is forward biased. So D1 and D2 won't conduct. D3 and D4 starts conducting. So from this transformer we are getting 180 degree phase shift, okay, out of phase of the carrier output. See, once again, I am explaining the operation of balanced modulator. If we are giving logic 1 to the balanced modulator, diode D1 and D2 is forward biased, so it starts conducting. It becomes a on. So D3 and D4 is reverse biased, so it is in off condition. So the carrier voltage developed across the transformer 0 degree. Carrier voltage developed across the transformer is 0 degree, that is in phase. Then we are giving logic 0 to the transformer. If we are giving logic 0 means D1 and D2, diode D1 and D2 is reverse biased. So it is in off condition. D3 and diode D4 is forward biased. It is in on condition. So carrier voltage developed across the transformer is 180 degree, that is out of phase. So in this way we are getting the PSK signal as the output of the balanced modulator. Okay, so in this way we are getting the PSK signal as the output from the balanced modulator diagram. Bandwidth of PSK is 2 FB/2, which is equal to FB, or else in some book they may use bandwidth is equal to 1 plus D into R. So this is the bandwidth of PSK signal. How we are getting the bandwidth is like this, because a balanced modulator is a product modulator. The output signal is the product of two input signal, isn't it? Output signal is the product of two input signals. So in a BPSK modulator, the carrier input signal is multiplied by the binary signal. Okay, carrier input is multiplied by the binary input. So PSK output is nothing but sine omega CT into sine omega CT, which is equal to sine squared omega CT. Okay, sine omega CT into sine omega CT, or else sine 2 pi sine squared 2 pi FCT. So in this, this is FB, this is C. FB, sorry, omega B. PSK output is sine 2 pi FBT into sine 2 pi FCT, isn't it? Okay, balanced modulator multiply the binary bit into carrier signal, isn't it? Carrier input signal is multiplied by binary value. So this may be sine 2 pi FBT into sine 2 pi FCT, isn't it? So in this, FB represents the binary data input, FC represents the carrier reference frequency. So this is bit frequency and this is carrier frequency, isn't it? Okay, this is bit frequency, FB nothing but the bit frequency, FC nothing but the carrier reference frequency. So the minimum bandwidth is 2 FB by 2, which is equal to FB. Or else we can say that 1 plus D into R. So this is the bandwidth of PSK. So once again, I'm telling the explanation for PSK modulation. So this is the block diagram of PSK modulation. So here we are giving the binary input data. Binary input data is applied to the input for the level converter. Level converter converts the binary values into bipolar NRZ level signal, which may be applied to the balanced modulator. At the same time, carrier signal is also applied to the balanced modulator. Balanced modulator is nothing but the product modulator. So it multiplies both the incoming signals, signal coming from the level converter and the carrier signal, both may be multiplied by the balanced modulator. So from the balanced modulator, we are getting the modulated PSK signal as the output. So balanced, we are familiar with this balanced modulator operation. Here we are giving PSK signal and this is band pass filter. This is balanced modulator, coherent carrier recovery, coherent carrier recovery. Sorry, coherent carrier recovery. Here, this is low pass filter, level converter, clock recovery. Binary data as output. So this is the PSK receiver block diagram or PSK demodulation block diagram. So these are all the blocks we are having in this block diagram. Band pass filter, balanced modulator, low pass filter, level converter. Here we are using coherent carrier recovery. This is clock recovery. So here the input may be plus sin omega ct or minus sin omega ct. From the coherent carrier recovery, we are getting the sin omega ct. So now I will explain the circuit operation. So here the input signal may be plus sin omega ct or minus sin omega ct. The coherent carrier recovery circuit detects and regenerates the carrier signal. Okay, the coherent carrier recovery block detects and regenerates the carrier signal, that is both frequency and phase, coherent with the original carrier signal. Balanced modulator is a product modulator, that is the output of the product of two input signals. Okay, balanced modulator is nothing but the product modulator. It multiplies both the incoming signal, carrier signal, and the signal coming from the input. Then low pass filter separates the recovered binary data from the demodulated signal. Now I'll explain the output of the balanced modulator. Okay, output of balanced modulator. So the main part of the diagram is the balanced modulator. I will explain how the output is recovered from the balanced modulator. Okay, for BPSK input signal is logic 1. Okay, if it is logic 1, that is plus sign omega CT. Logic 1, suppose we are giving logic 1 signal, so the output of the balanced modulator is sin omega CT into sin omega, which is equal to sin squared omega CT, isn't it? Because the BPSK signal may be plus or minus sin omega CT here. Coherent carrier recovery detects and regenerates the carrier signal, sin omega CT. So, one input, if we are giving logic 1, it means that plus sin omega CT. So, here also we are giving plus sin omega CT. Then coherent carrier recovery regenerates the carrier signal. So, here also one input is sin omega CT. So, here also sin omega CT. So, the output of balanced modulator may be output may be sin squared omega CT, isn't it? We know that sin squared omega CT is equal to 1 minus cos 2 omega CT by 2, isn't it? Okay, sin squared omega CT is equal to 1 minus cos 2 omega CT by 2. So, we can write this means 1 by 2. We can expand this. I am expanding this one. 1 by 2 minus 1 by 2 into cos 2 omega CT. So the output of balanced modulator is equal to positive, isn't it? 1 by 2 is positive. So it may be considered as logic 1. Then output of balanced modulator is logic 0, means output is equal to minus sin omega CT into carrier recovery generates sin omega CT 1. Okay, so this means minus sin squared omega CT, which is equal to minus one by two sorry minus sin squared omega CT. Minus 1 by 2 into 1 minus cos 2 omega CT. Wait, isn't it? So I am expanding this. I will be getting minus 1 by 2 minus of minus plus 1 by 2 cos 2 omega CT. So the output is minus 1 by 2. So it means that a negative. So we are getting logic 0 data at the output of balanced modulator. So once again, I'm explaining the PSK demodulation block diagram. So what are all the blocks we are having in the block diagram? Band pass filter, balanced modulator, low pass filter, level converter, clock recovery, coherent carrier recovery. Okay, so these are all the blocks available in this diagram. So PSK signal is the input for this block diagram. So it may be plus or minus sin omega CT. Coherent carrier recovery regenerates and detects the carrier signal. So this is nothing but sin omega CT. So here also, if we are applying logic 1 plus sin omega ct means output of the balanced modulator is sin squared omega ct. So we are getting the binary data 1 from the block diagram. So if we are giving a logic 0 means we are getting the negative voltage. So logic 0 we are getting from this block diagram. What is the use of coherent carrier recovery? It detects and regenerates the carrier signal. So the use of low pass filter, it separates the recovered binary data from the complex demodulated signal. Okay, so it separates the binary data from the demodulated signal. Low pass filter separates the binary data from the demodulated signal. Then I am going to list out some of the advantages. PSK is better than ASK and FSK. Bandwidth of PSK is better than FSK. Then noise immunity is better. Noise immunity is better than FSK. So these are all the some of the advantages of PSK. Okay. So PSK system is better than the ASK and FSK. Bandwidth of PSK is better than that of the FSK system. Noise immunity is also better than that of the FSK signal. Then drawbacks. Disadvantages. Detection of PSK is quite complex. Detection of the PSK signal is quite complex. Then it is costly. The system is very costly. No non-coherent detection is available. No non-coherent receiver is there in that of the PSK system. So these are all the some of the disadvantages. Detection of PSK is quite complex. It is costly system. No non-coherent receiver is needed for PSK system. Applications. Biometric operation. It is used in biometric operation. Then Bluetooth connectivity. PSK system used in Bluetooth connectivity. Wireless LAN. It is used in wireless LAN. Then it is used in telemetry operation. And also used in digital communication systems. So these are all the some of the applications of PSK I have listed here. Thank you so much. If you are not subscribe my channel, please subscribe my channel. Press the subscribe button below this video. Thank you so much.